Okay, hey, in this video, I'm gonna talk about five things that are gonna happen in 2023 that you need to know about in drone LiDAR today. If this is the first time we're meeting, I'm Dan Hubert. I am marketing in Phoenix LiDAR. And I've been working with these guys for just a few months, but I've actually been in the LiDAR industry for well over 8 years. And so I'm gonna show you some trends and some things that are gonna happen in 2023 that you really need to know. So the first thing we're gonna see is a continuation into miniaturization. Okay, so DJI came out with the L1, we have the Recon A, but more importantly, you know, the size of the drones are decreasing and the ability for us to be a back of the truck solution is important. This allows, you know, enterprises to use very large systems for huge area collection and small systems for spot checks, small areas, and this is going to allow us to maximize profits because you're not waiting around for expensive assets. You've got something that fits in the back of a trunk. And more importantly, we're gonna see more and more of US-made sensors that are at that small form factor. And number two, we're going to see extended ranges. We're seeing a maturity within the FAA and we're seeing more beyond line of sight waivers. This is important not just for the small sensors, but also for the large sensors that are on the market. You know, a large sensor could cost you anywhere from $100,000 all the way up to $250,000, $300,000. And, you know, when you're starting to get into those higher accuracy, higher price point systems, you want them to fly longer so you can collect more area. And so these beyond line of sight waivers are really important because traditionally, you know, when I first started with like the utilities, we couldn't use drones because we couldn't cover enough area and a helicopter was more affordable. But what we're seeing through 2023 is now that some of these corridors and some of these continued flight areas out in rural space are being flown and waivers are being granted, now the cost of using a drone is decreasing or the area that we are covering is much more effective. Okay, number three from our prediction is you're gonna see a lot more of AI and machine learning coming out in the drone space or the LiDAR space in 2023. So, I mean, I'm sure everybody knows about ChatGPT, whatever. What we've seen going on in the LiDAR space is more of using AI for classification. And we've been seeing this going on for a period of years, but this year I've seen a dramatic increase in the ability to use AI, especially for classification. So if you want to use something like LiDAR Mill, for instance, you can use some of our AI algorithms that are going to help classify your data sets. This doesn't mean that you don't have a human in the loop for quality control. It just makes your workflow faster and more convenient. And so for those that have been doing it by hand, you can tell you how long that really takes, and this is usually a game changer. Number four is you're gonna see more data fusion. And so as LiDAR is becoming more and more acceptable, you're gonna be able to pull different data sets together and merge them. We particularly see this in like DOT, where we have ground mobile mappers going, and then they need to fill in the gaps for cut and fill or watershed, and they'll fly a drone over the berms or out into the erosion areas that they need to take into consideration. And so things like LiDAR Snap inside of SE Pro or LiDAR Mill will help where you actually can match one LiDAR data set to another data set and lock those in seamlessly. Another thing part of that is also being able to push those products from, let's say, LiDAR Mill into your other applications. So having that data fusion as it goes through the entire workflow is really important, and you'll see this with our LAN XML app as it pushes it out to Civil 3D and some of the other more popular third-party point cloud applications. And the fifth thing to talk about is reality capture workflows. So as we start to see more and more adoption, you know, getting these solutions to be simple and easy to use is critical, especially for small survey firms that traditionally have not been doing drone work recently. And so using things like mission guidance that allows you to lay out your entire project in a Google Earth metric and then being able to superimpose your LiDAR flight planning over top of that so that it is pretty much a push of the button, take off, do your capture, land, and you make sure you have a good data product is more of what you're going to see in 2023. So I hope this has actually been helpful for you. And if you have any more questions or you have some comments or things you want to learn, go ahead and leave a comment in below. We do read those as I try to tailor the content here that are going to be helpful for you. And with that, I'll see you in the next video.